When I first started making videos here on YouTube back in 2018, I think it's fair to say most of the world was still more or less fast asleep when it came to the concept of a climate emergency, or any kind of energy transition for that matter. Pressure groups like Extinction Rebellion and Greta Thunberg's Fridays for Future movement hadn't yet burst onto the global scene. And even Elon Musk's Tesla Motors was still little more than a fringe novelty anywhere outside of California, having sold only about 60,000 Model S and Model X cars in that state and barely another 40,000 throughout the rest of the world. Cutting-edge lithium-ion battery technology was running at an energy density of only just over 200 watt-hours per kilogram, and owning one of those newfangled electrical vehicles was very much a dim and distant prospect for the vast majority of people. The variable that most of us were completely ignoring in our calculus, though, was something called China. Fast forward to the present day, and all those years of, frankly, arrogance and complacency by Western manufacturers means all our national automotive industries are now scrambling like crazy to catch up with better, more advanced, and less expensive technology now flooding inexorably our way from the east like water from a burst dam. Battery energy density has more than doubled in just a few years, while cell prices have tumbled by more than 80%. And now the world's largest battery maker is talking very soberly and seriously about getting us all into the skies with their technology. Our times change, eh? Hello, and welcome to Just Have a Think. We'll get to that astonishing battery-powered civil aviation claim later in the video. But let's first take a look at how we got there. I'm sure you well-informed folks know already that the two really big dogs of the modern battery industry are China's CATL and BYD. In 2023, those two companies alone made up more than 50% of global battery market share. And whatever your views about China's political and industrial strategy, and by the way, I'm not here to try and defend either of those things in case you're wondering, but whatever your views about them, the fact is that BYD, CATL, and others in China are racing ahead at an eye-watering pace to discover and develop the next generation of battery chemistry and construction that'll take the global energy transition to an entirely different level. There are now electric vehicles like the Li Mega MPV and Zeekr 001 on Chinese roads today with batteries that can support 5C charging, for example. And for those who haven't yet immersed themselves in the fascinating and not at all nerdy world of battery technology, the C rate is defined by people far smarter than me as the rate at which a battery is charged or discharged relative to its nominal capacity. And it's expressed as a multiple of the battery's capacity. So for example, a battery with a 1C rating is capable of charging or discharging its full capacity in 1 hour. Charging at 5 times that rate was until fairly recently a highly inadvisable thing to attempt, usually resulting in a fried battery and quite possibly a nasty fire. But that 5C charge rate has now been made safe and available, which means these batteries can theoretically go from 0 to 100% charge in just 12 minutes. Obviously, to actually achieve those charge rates in the real world, you need a suitably powerful charger. To achieve even 4C charging in one of those EVs I've just mentioned, we're talking about a 480 kilowatt machine pumping electrons out at a rate of 615 amps. And there aren't too many of those around, even in China. They are coming though, and they'll be needed in large numbers if the infrastructure is to keep pace with the advancements in battery chemistry. There are, of course, some real great technical developments happening in other parts of the world as well, including Europe and North America, and we've covered several of those in recent videos. But for the purposes of this video, I'm going to focus on BYD and CATL to try to understand how their own competitive race has been driving both companies forward at breakneck speed. In 2022, CATL launched the Tillion battery, which was the third generation of the company's so-called cell-to-pack or CTP technology, which aimed to optimize not just the cell chemistry, but also the structural way the packs are put together. By integrating cells directly into the structural pack design, rather than manufacturing them in modules, they achieved a much more compact system, which effectively results in greater efficiency. That design also allowed for multiple liquid cooling plates and thermal pads to sit between cell layers in a sandwich-like structure instead of having just a single plate above the crossbeam. That increased heat transfer fourfold compared to previous iterations of the design, which meant the cells could be brought up to working temperature in 5 minutes from a cold start. It also meant the battery could technically be charged up from 10 to 80% in just 10 minutes if you were lucky enough to be parked next to one of those big old public chargers. So while the Chilin battery's boilerplate energy density of 255 watt-hours per kilogram wasn't earth-shattering, the efficiency with which that energy was delivered was certainly a step change from previous technology, giving the cells a claimed volume utilization efficiency of 72% compared to 63% for a standard 4680 cell like those being developed at Tesla Motors. Meanwhile, over at the main competitor BYD, a rival innovation called the blade battery was being developed. The idea here was to arrange very long blade-like cells into a densely packed arrangement that BYD claimed to improve both structural integrity and thermal stability. The blade-like design allowed for a more compact and space-efficient battery pack, increasing the overall capacity without taking up additional space. And the design maximized the overall surface area available for heat dissipation as well, which meant much greater thermal stability. The battery chemistry is lithium iron phosphate, which means no cobalt or nickel. It also means inherently lower risk of thermal runaway. BYD proudly presented us with this famous nail test footage, comparing the slightly disturbing incendiary device that NMC packs turn into when they're breached in this way, with the totally benign response that they achieved from one of their new blade configurations during the same test conditions. They also drove a 46-ton truck over one of the packs to demonstrate just how robust it was. All good PR stuff, of course, but nevertheless, a powerful selling point in terms of durability. BYD also claim an operational lifespan of at least 3,000 cycles, or about 1.2 million kilometres. The company's now got a brand new state-of-the-art dedicated production facility with an annual capacity of 35 gigawatt hours worth of cells, which is a lot, enough for more than 500,000 mid-sized EVs. And they've even managed to infiltrate the hallowed ground of Tesla Motors, with blade batteries now being supplied to all new Model Y vehicles produced at Tesla's Berlin Gigafactory. According to the online journal Car News China, the next generation of blade technology is set to be released later in 2024 with an upgraded energy density that could deliver over 600 miles of range from a similar sized pack to existing production. Not to be outdone though, CATL hit back with what it calls a condensed battery, which ramps up energy density so significantly that it takes the industry all the way to the cusp of electrically powered commercial aviation. Battery chemists have been speculating about the exact chemical composition of these things, but one of the key innovations that CATL claims to have integrated is a technology called biomimetic interfaces in the electrolyte. So what the heck are they then? Well, according to these science bods, they're polymer structures that accumulate at the surface of the lithium metal anode and have the rather useful feature of being electrically conductive while also having the capability to block the dreaded dendrites that are a very unwelcome byproduct, particularly in solid lithium metal anodes, and which have plagued the development of solid state batteries, as we found out in a recent video. The upshot is an extremely safe battery with a very long operational lifespan and an astonishing energy density of 500 watt-hours per kilogram, which is the benchmark at which many analysts suggest commercial passenger flights might just be achievable. And sure enough, at a recent World Economic Forum gathering in Dalian, northwest China, CATL announced that it's teamed up with the Commercial Aircraft Corporation of China to develop an electric commercial airplane with a flight range of up to 3,000 kilometres that they say will be ready by 2027 or 28. CATL's chief scientist, Wu Kai, told delegates at the meeting that his team has already carried out test flights with a 4-ton civilian aircraft as part of the journey toward a full production 8-ton 3,000 kilometre electric aircraft within 4 years. Now, no one's talking about crossing any oceans in battery electric planes anytime soon, but 3,000 kilometres gets you from Xinjiang in the west of China all the way to Shanghai in the east. So you can see why it's an attractive proposition to the Chinese government. 3,000 kilometres, or 1,900 miles, also gets you from Atlanta, Georgia to Los Angeles in California, for example, which is not to be sniffed at. And let's face it, any reduction in the emissions from commercial aviation has to be a good thing, doesn't it? According to this 2023 research paper, the US aviation industry is set to grow at about 2% per year running up to 2050. And if the emissions that our current technology produces are not addressed adequately, then by mid-century, America's aircraft alone will be responsible for about 430 million tonnes of carbon dioxide per year. And of course, a similar challenge exists here in Europe as well. So if the majority of that travel can be achieved via zero carbon electric aircraft, then we'll have gone a long way to solving at least one of our climate emergency dilemmas, don't you think? Or maybe you don't think so, who knows? Whichever way you fall on that argument, or if you've got additional snippets of industry info about the battery developments we've looked at today, then as always, the place to leave your thoughts is in the comments section below. That's it for this week though. A massive thank you, as always, to the channel's Patreon supporters who help me stay independent and keep ads and sponsorship messages out of your way. If you enjoy these videos and you feel like you could support the channel for about the price of a coffee each month, then jump over to patreon.com/justhaveathink to have a look at the exclusive benefits you can enjoy there. And of course, you can massively support us absolutely for free by hitting the like and subscribe buttons and clicking on all notifications. It's just a simple click away either down there or on that icon there. As always though, thanks very much for watching. Have a great week and remember to just have a think. See you next week.